Good morning, everyone. Carol here at Oak House Generals. Big warm welcome from me, as always. And because I've got the guest cheques in front of me, you'll know that I'm going in with prompt number 7 of the 50 Stack Challenge, which is being hosted by Crafty Cat. And all the information is in the description box below the video if the challenge or project is new to you. So I'm lifting out my prepared guest cheque number 7 for prompt number 7. And the prompt for this one was lace. So, as you can see, I've got some laces here to one side. I've got some tiny little vintage trim here, which I might or might not use. I've got this gorgeous piece of vintage lace. And as you can see, I've already taken a wee portion out. I love this. Let me flip it over because that's the wrong side. No, this is the right side, sorry. I love this little lace and look at that detail on the bottom. So I thought I might use that along the edge of a photograph or this, but not for my main lace on my piece and or on my altered guest cheque. And then I have this lace. Now, this is absolutely exquisite. And what I thought I would do initially was to make a lace sampler using my guest cheque and put in it some bits of my vintage lace. That would have been a really easy hit for this altered guest cheque. But when it came down to it and I was going through my laces, I just didn't want to sacrifice them to make a sampler, because once they're made up as a sampler on my guest cheque, I couldn't use them. So I decided not to do that, and I decided to use a little portion of this to create a pocket. I'm hoping it will be pretty, and the reason I want it to be pretty is because I want to alter my guest cheque and use this photo. And this is a picture of my grandmother. Now, I don't panic, I have several copies of this image of grandma. As you can see, this one has come out of an old album. I've also got this lovely piece of embossed paper, and I'm going to be using that. And I love it particularly because of the background colour tones, but also these very, very delicate pinks. And I've got a piece of handmade paper here, which is a perfect match. So what I thought I would do is use this as my background. Now, as you can see, it's short, so I do need to do a bit of mix and matching. What I thought I might do is use, if I hold it there, use half of this. So I've laid my piece of lace out on my guest cheque to try and give you an idea of what I'm thinking. So I'm going to use half of this scroll here down the edge of my guest cheque. I'm going to use this paper as my background, and as you can see, it is short down here. What I think I'm going to be able to do is get this point here to line up with the edge of my guest cheque. So I'm going to snip my fabric or my lace round here till I get to this point, so that I've got all of this corner and a little bit of the bottom as my pocket. So that's the theory. It's going to need some careful snipping, I think. My first thing to do is get my background piece on here and trim to size, then have a think of or about what size I want my tag to be with Nana on it. And I am going to back it with this pink so that I pick up the pinks on here. And I think I will probably use this to do some edging as well. So first things first, I'm going to put the camera in hyperlapse so you can see what I'm doing and make a start on this. Okay, so I've cut my lace out and already you will have noticed a change of plan. I did wonder whether or not to leave a little portion of the really decorative lace down here. It just seems such a shame to snip it away. I'm not sure at the moment whether it's working. What I have realised is I was trying to take it up to the actual point of this scalloped edge before it went down to the next piece, and actually I've realized that I didn't need to do that. I can actually cut it away beforehand, and I am going to be stitching all of this on my machine, so I'm pretty comfortable that I can give it a little bit of a stretch and hold this pocket in place here because of the stitching on either side, so it's not going to be floppy. What is making me wonder is whether or not I actually do need to snip it down lower. This bit isn't looking quite right, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to just pop this to one side now and deal with grandma. Okay, so I think I'm going to have a fairly narrow tag for grandma to be on. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to fold a portion of this away, and as you can see it's cracking, so it's going to be a little bit unforgiving. I was going to rip that, but I think what I might do actually is to cut it on my guillotine. So I'm thinking something like that. I did wonder about doing something like that on there. It just will be a bit odd if I do it on one side, and if I do it on the other, it's going to close the whole thing in too much. I love how delicate this is, so that's why I'm kind of thinking I might make use of this. So let me have a look. Do you know, I really can't tell which side this trim needs to go. I think it's that way. It's so difficult to see, really. It really is. I think it's that way. So I was thinking maybe I could do something like this. I can just move it and get it into place so I can get a bit of an idea of what it's going to look like. Thought I could do something a little bit like that, so that I'm getting the pink coming through, and then stitch along the edge of Nana's photo. Oh, didn't think to check the size. Yeah, I'm gonna go with that. Or do I put it on top? That's my other thought. Oh, that's my back door closing. It's a gorgeous sunny day here and I've had the door open so that I can get a nice breeze coming through both the window and through from the back door. I'm liking that actually, everybody, so I think I'm going to go with that. So let me trim up this piece of paper behind. Whilst I'm working with this paper, I'm thinking that whilst it won't make my whole tag too thick, what I am bothered about is that as this is going in and out of the pocket, this paper is quite delicate. So I think I'm going to end up having to double it up, really, so that it has a bit of sturdiness on the edges. So I've decided to chop the top off this photograph. It was making it too tall for the pocket, and I thought I might like to put a topper on here. I've ripped off the edge of this piece of lace, and I've made a decision that I'm going to just edge down each side with some of this. So all I'm going to do now is I'm going to put a dab of glue just to hold it where I think I want it to go, because as I've mentioned before, I'm going to be sewing this tag. So I'm going to put a dab of glue down there, and I'm just going to try and get the detail on the edge. Now let me just offer that up so I can see what it's going to look like. I haven't got much room to play with, so I might need to pull that over off the edge of my backing, like so. Yeah, that's better. So it's almost, I can just get the little leaves on the edge, which gives me some detail. About a little bit of that on the bottom just to finish it off. I think it's too heavy. As much as I lifted it out thinking it would work, I think it's too heavy. So I might have to look for a little offcut of this to go on the top here, which I think would be nice. Maybe those leaves there, which I thought about cutting off before. And then this piece doesn't sit right along the bottom, it's not big enough, but what I could do is just use another little piece of this along the bottom just to finish it off, and I think those two little daisies down there are going to do the business. So I'm going to snip and rip. This will go in my scrap pot in front of me, certainly won't get wasted. And this piece is going to go along the bottom, so I'm just going to trim off this. And this little piece can go along the bottom there. So I'm going to put some glue. And I think when that's sewn, that will look pretty. And let's see if I want to use those leaves. Those leaves aren't looking right to me, so I am going to snip them off there. Okay, this is where I've got to on my little tag. I've put a little bit more of, oh, that's glued down. I've put a little bit more of that voile across the top just to soften this top edge. And my photo is going to sit like that. I was thinking about having that across the top, but it's not quite working for me to do that. So I'm going to put it across that corner there. Ideally, because the tag is going into the pocket with lace down the left-hand side, ideally that would have been better on that side, but it doesn't work because it's too close to Nana's head and we have all this extra space up there. So I need to position my tag carefully in my pocket, but I'm thinking that would go up there. I've trimmed off a little bit more across the bottom here. You probably can't see that at all with this background, but there we go, you can probably see it now under my hand. I've trimmed off a little bit more, and that's what I've trimmed off. So I'm going to just put that across the bottom on this little tag as well. So what I'm going to do now with this is I'm going to glue this photo of Nana in place onto the background, and then I'm going to go around and stitch it on my machine and then come back and glue these pieces in. I'm not going to stitch over these pieces because they're so tiny, they're probably going to move as I'm trying to stitch them on my machine. And I actually don't want stitch lines going over the top of this lace. So that's what I'm going to do on this one. So I'll quickly do that now before I go away and stitch. The stitching will be my belt braces on here. So there we go, just like that. So I'm just going to use my bone folder. And I will be going in and just fraying up the edges a bit more when it's all secure in place. As you can see, I've already gone in and done a little bit of fraying up there. And then on this piece, I am going to put a dab of glue down this left-hand side and along the bottom and up the side here, just to hold my lace in place. My card, or my guest cheque, is curling a little bit, but that'll flatten out in due course. So those are all just held nicely in place. I'm not sure that I'm going to like the stitching across the bottom here on this. The stitching is going to be hidden on that side, and it won't be too noticeable. And I like the fact that it's just going off the top a little bit there. And as you can see, it's certainly going off the bottom. I think I might need to put a little bit more glue up the side here. I don't think I went high enough. There we go. And as you know, art glitter glue dries dry, or clear rather. Dries dry. Okay, Carol. It dries clear, so it is beautiful. You won't see any of that. And when it is dry and after I've stitched, then I will just flip it over and trim off this edge here. And I might actually leave these edges like that. So I'm just going to go away now and machine this and my tag, and then glue these pieces in place. And then I think we're done. See you in a moment. So these are my pieces stitched all the way around. I've stitched down here, across the bottom. It doesn't look too bad, actually. I thought I wasn't going to like it stitched across the bottom here. And rather than stopping my stitching at the edge of my tag, I've just taken it all the way round. I did wonder about doing some messy stitching around the seven up there. As you saw earlier on in the video, I just ripped out a portion of this lovely embossed paper. So I've stitched all the way around that. All I'm going to do now is I'm going to trim away this portion down here. And just using my bone folder, I'm going to just smooth my stitching out on the reverse here. And actually, if I thought about it, on both of these tags, or the tag and the altered guest check, I probably would have waited to back them until I'd done my stitching, because I quite like having a neat back and not seeing all the stitching. But it actually doesn't look too bad on this tag. It's not so good on this one. But then again, I'm not sure what I'm going to do with these. I think I might actually make a book out of them all, but we'll see. So that's my little snippet of lace from the side there. And I'm just looking to see whether or not I can make use of it anywhere. Probably not on this tag. I think it's going to be way too much because I have these two little bits. So I'm just going to get my art glitter glue, put a dab of glue up in this top corner up here, and pop that in the corner like so, and then a little bit across the corner here just for some more interest. And there we go. Distress these edges up a little bit more up there. And there we have it, everybody. I'm going to call that a finished altered guest cheque for this week. I'm going to pop that in my pot and use it another day. Just wipe round very quickly. So there we go. That's my prompt, which was lace. This is my tag to pop in the pocket. And it's not too bad, actually, having that in that corner. I've moved my tag right over to the right hand side. And actually, if I put that piece of the lace pocket underneath, it will sit okay, I think. Or I can equally have it over the top. But I think I like it popped underneath like that. So there we go, everybody. This is my number 7 altered guest cheque. And I hope you liked it. So I'll do some pictures at the end so that you can have a closer look. And I'll see you for prompt number 8, which I believe is vellum. So until then, bye-bye for now.